I learned that our time here is temporary.
Kelsey, Peyton, Amber, and Job owe me something at the end.
For 8 years, head volleyball coach Jennifer McCauley has been building strong girls.
Go, Amber!
She pushes them to finish workouts and motivates her team to do their best.
Good job today. We got lots of work to do. Tigers on three. One, two, three.
Tigers!
And that motivation, the very thing she's been teaching, is exactly what she clinged to for the last year in her own life. It was her test for some of the most grueling days of her life. It all started March of 2011.
I got put in the hospital and I just wasn't feeling good. And I really was having a hard time breathing. At the time they were talking about adrenal fatigue. And so they kind of got me going again, but through that stint, I had about two or three, I had three times in the hospital.
McCauley didn't return to the friendship courts or her sophomore English class after that. She was trying to figure out, with doctor visit after doctor visit, what could possibly be making her feel so horrible.
My joints started aching, and then later I started feeling flu-like symptoms, tired all the time.
McCauley slowly started losing weight, and her athletic ability dwindled away.
Some of my ex-players would come visit me, and I used to run with them, and they would end up helping me walk around the house just to get some form of exercise.
By July of 2011, McCauley flew out to California for treatments. She tested positive for Lyme disease, but she says the treatments weren't making her better, but worse.
You know, we had tried California, we had gone to New York.
McCauley still grew weaker by August, and her faith was being tested.
It seemed like everything we tried or every doctor we tried to turn to, it was not helping. I was losing my hair. There was so many times where I was just so discouraged. I would wake up in the morning going, oh, okay, it didn't go away. Another day.
Then these started to appear on her hands. Oh, sores. Not just small ones, but large, painful sores on the palm of her hands. She thought it happened because she had to use her hands to get around, but it was actually a sign of death. Her circulatory system was so inflamed, it would have killed her by Christmas.
We started aggressive treatments because we had to.
Not only did she have Lyme disease, but this new discovery pointed to an autoimmune condition. Her body was essentially attacking itself in the form of six diseases.
I was wheelchair bound. I couldn't even lift my arms up this high without excruciating pain. Your body attacks a certain thing, like your muscles, polymyositis, your skin, dermatomyositis, lupus, scleroderma, rheumatoid arthritis. I mean, it was just so many things that my body just went crazy.
Oh, hugs. I love you!
McCauley is feeling stronger these days. She was doing IV treatments of steroids and chemo to bring the swelling down in her body. She's been off chemo since last month and is back in the saddle again.
See? Yay!
Simple things like opening a jar are signs she's getting her strength back. And as she remembers her nightmare, she says she's thankful for the rays of light in her moment of darkness.
Miss Robinson at Bennett, Alta Swindle, English Department, Amy Smallwood, Julie Pratt, Mandy Coors, the wonderful nurses at the high school. It was just overwhelming. I mean, my kids had the best Christmas ever. And so I told them not to expect that again next year, because mom's healthy. But Terry, Kim, I mean, it was just Brad.
These are my high school coaches that stepped in while I was gone for the whole season, and they did a fantastic job. Everybody stepped up and took part, and I appreciate all their work for doing what they had to do with one less coach.
It was kind of nice when coaches would come and tell me what was going on at school, so it helped me forget a little bit about what was going on in my world, and I could kind of enjoy getting lost in what was going on at school, so it was good therapy.
Courage is the quality of mind or spirit that enables a person to face difficulty, danger, and pain with bravery. Welcome back, Jennifer McCauley. Welcome back.